I want you to be so much more productive within Gmail, and I'm going to show you how to do that by introducing you to some new Gmail extensions. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And today, I want to show you some extensions, some Gmail add-ons from cloudhq. Now, cloudhq actually has nearly 40 different Gmail extensions to help you be more productive, but I want to share with you three of my favorites. And we're going to get things started with Gmail tabs. Here at the top of the screen, you will see that I have a few different labels. These are called Gmail tabs. And once you have the extension installed, the first one you're going to see is your default, your inbox, but you can now add additional tabs at the top of your inbox. So a few weeks ago, I showed you a very simple Gmail workflow using a couple of labels that I have here. Action required and waiting for response. But you'll probably recognize if you're a Gmail user that after you have about five or so labels, this can get really difficult to manage here. You're scrolling up and down. You may even have some that are hidden down below. Where do you go and find those labels? Well, why not have the ones that you use most frequently at your fingertips at the top of the screen? If I select action required, it's just going to immediately go to all of those emails there. If I want to select waiting for response, it's immediately going to show me any of the emails with that particular label. So how do you use it? Well, let's say I want this completed label to be up top here as well. All I need to do is select these little three dots, which gives me some more options. And once you have the extension installed, you'll see this little cloudhq menu edition. In this case, I'm going to select add to tabs including sublabels, and you can see immediately I now have it at the top of my screen. I can click on it and all of my emails that have that particular label will appear. Now on the right hand side, there's an edit tab function. If I want to clean things up, I can remove that asterisk. The only reason I added that asterisk is that I wanted this to sort at the top of my labels because I knew how difficult it was to manage labels over here. So I'm going to remove that asterisk. I'm going to hit save. Now it's a lot cleaner. You can also rearrange these as well, right? I can rearrange the order of my tabs. So let's drag it. I want to drag that all the way to the end. Why isn't it moving it over there? There we go. So I can drag things around if I want to, hit done, and now I've got my tabs here at the top. But let me click over to the inbox for one more second. I want to show you an additional way to add a tab here, because you don't have to have an existing label. In fact, you don't have to use labels at all if you don't want to. I'm going to type in Best Buy here in the search bar because I know I've got a bunch of emails here by Best Buy. And let's say this is something that I'd like to review or I'd like to take a look at on a regular basis. Well, you'll notice I now have another option here called Add to Tabs. So I'm going to select that option, Add to Tabs, and immediately I've got this filter. So even if I get new Best Buy messages going forward, it's going to show up underneath this tab. And if I don't like the way that it looks there, let's go in here. I'm going to hit Edit, and let's give it the proper capital B. Space, capital B, we'll hit save, we're gonna hit done. So I've just immediately created this filter. It's not a particular label, but now I've added it to my tabs area. So you might wanna check out Gmail tabs. All right, let's move on to extension number two, and this all has to do with saving time when you are crafting a message within Gmail. So here I am, I've opened up a brand new message, and I think perhaps the most common scenario for this particular add-on is going to be when you're replying to someone. And think about some of the questions that you reply to very, very often, right? It's the same set of wording, it's the same sentences that you use time and time again. Well, why not just save those phrases? Maybe you could even save an entire email and then retrieve it with just a few clicks. So at the bottom of the screen here, you'll see I have this little T plus. That lets me know that I have Gmail snippets installed. And all I have to do is select the backwards slash on my keyboard, and it's going to pop up this tiny menu here that is showing me all of these preloaded phrases, which either I've created or the ones that we're looking at right now are some of the default ones. So I can either use my cursor, but probably what's easier is just to use the arrow keys because I already typed something in on my keyboard, and I can select this answer one, hit enter, boom. I've got that phrase right in there. Let's hit backslash again, and I'm going to say, thanks for using our app. Boom. There it is. Now, those are two very, very short sentences. You can craft an entire email if you like to. So let's go down to the settings here. I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to say, you've got two options here. We can either create a new snippet from this message. That's actually a really smart idea. If there's a particular email that you do quite frequently or phrases that you use quite frequently, you can actually create it from the particular message. But let's select browse snippets here. And here you can see all of the ones that we have installed so far. Each has a shortcut name or a shortcut itself, a name, and then the content itself. And of course, you can always edit and delete these ones as well. I'm going to select add just to show you how easy it is to add a new snippet. I'm just going to call this one test. The name, I'm going to say test as well. And I'm just going to say this is a test snippet from CloudHQ. All right, now remember, again, you can add a lot more text than just a single sentence. You can have paragraphs in here. You can have line spaces if you want. And at the bottom, you can even add a few variables as well, including name, including email, or day of the week. I'll show you that in just a moment. So I'm going to save this one here. You can see that it's been added here to this list. And if you get a really long list, you can even search for all of your snippets here as well. I'm going to hit done, and I'm going to go back to my email. So I'm going to go down a line. I'm going to hit backslash again. And I don't see test in this menu, right? It's only going to show you about six here in this first preview. But if I start typing in T, well, now I just get the thanks with T and hey, test. There's my test one. So I can input that one immediately. Let me show you this other one that has this day of the week built right into it. I'm going to go backslash and this one, what is the day of the, it's blank here because it's going to built into this functionality. If I hit return and have a fantastic Tuesday. And that's right, it is Tuesday today. So no matter what day of the week it is, it's going to automatically input that into this particular phrase. So you might want to check out snippets, especially if you want to save time replying and writing those very, very lengthy emails. All right, I'm going to close up this message for just a second, but we're going to get back into that for our third and final Gmail extension. And that has to do with email tracking. And I want you to think of how many times have you sent an important email, or maybe you've reached out to a particular client and you wish you'd know when they open up that email. Because when can you follow up with a phone call? When can you follow up with another email? When would be the ideal time to check back in with them? You want to know when they have read the email. I don't mean reply, but when have they read the email? So let me type in an email address to a test account that we're going to use here. And I'm just going to call this test tracking in this case. And I'm not even going to include a message. I don't need a message for this because we just want to track when this person has actually read this particular email. So down below, you can see there's a little, it almost looks like a Wi-Fi signal, but this is the icon for email tracking options. So if I click on this, I have a few different selections I can choose here. I can get it to automatically send me a reply or send me an email if this person doesn't reply in a couple of days. But really what I'm after here is this send me an email upon open. When they open it, I want to be notified of it. And there's a few other options you can choose from here as well, including send me a text message. You can get a text alert if you want. But I'm just going to keep this one selected. Send me an email when this person opens this particular email. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go right ahead. I'm going to select send. All right, so it just sends the email like a normal email. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to switch over to this to that test account here. And of course, email is not always instantaneous, but let's see if I can receive. There it is. There's that email. This is this test tracking email. So of course, it's unread at this state, right? I haven't clicked on it yet. So I'm going to click on this message. Of course, now it has been read. Let's see what happens if we go back to our original account. So let's go back to our Gmail account. And it may take a few seconds. I mean, it may take up to a minute or so. I'm going to refresh my inbox here to see how quickly it's going to actually come back and notify me that that particular message has been read. All right, so there it is. Here at the top of my email, I've got an email from, it's giving me a notification saying that this email address has just read, and here's the subject line. Now, if I click on the message itself, it's gonna give me some more details. So-and-so has read your email less than a minute after it was sent. So it's gonna tell me how long it actually sat in their inbox before they read it. It's gonna give me details sent on, read on, location, if it can give it to me. And it's even gonna give me a small preview of the message down below. So if I'm curious, like which email was that? What was that email about? It's gonna let me know here down below as well. So regardless if this is a sales conversation, if you need to follow up with confirming a particular date, maybe now that you know that they've read it, you're going to follow up with a different message, or you're going to give them a phone call an hour from now. So if you want a very useful and free email tracking tool, you might want to check out the tracking tool from CloudHQ. I'll be sure to include a link to all of these tools so you can try them out yourself. And I'd love to hear from you next. Which of these three are you most excited about? Which of these three are going to be most helpful to your workday or most helpful to your business? Be sure to let me know down in the comments below. I want to thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you subscribe right here to Simpletivity. Please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to leave me a comment or a question down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.